he still there? He is. Yo, they're just gonna deny all my tags like that, bro. Come on. You're so mad, dude. Somebody just saved my life. They're being really honest. Where'd he go? Oh yeah, you're so mad, kid. Like, how many of my times are gonna get denied? Like, holy shit.
You fucking pussy.
He just called me a pussy, bro.
Yo, I gotta get one thing straight. You gotta tell me this shit, though. Why your girl bum? I don't wanna pop my goddamn trunk. I don't wanna smoke myself with a scum.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Zai. Welcome back to another video on the channel for you guys today. And as you guys can clearly see by the title and the thumbnail of today's video, the AX50 is the best weapon I've ever used in Modern Warfare. So I added this variable zoom scope to it, and it just makes this gun 10 times better. So guys, if you have this scope unlocked, use it, because the default scope feels weird. Like, it's either too zoomed in when you zoom in, or it's too zoomed out when you don't have it zoomed in, if that makes sense. But with this scope, it feels just like the Ballista from Black Ops 2. So I advise you guys use this scope and make the switch right now. So I just recently changed the scope on the AX50 to the variable zoom one, I believe it is. And this gun is feeling more like the Ballista from Black Ops 2 now. Like, I'm actually finally getting the hang of this weapon. Because with the default scope, this gun was either aimed in like really close or just like zoomed out really far, if that makes sense. But with this variable zoom scope, like, this is just the right zoom, which makes this gun feel so nice. Like, look at that. Like, I'm actually slaying. Like, I'm slaying right now. Holy smokes, this weapon feels nice now. You're mad, kid. You're mad, kid. I'm mad, kid. Oh god. So yesterday, Kiwis actually posted a cutcom to his second channel, and honestly, like, I just missed the days when they were back at the Red House and they were posting like COD cutcoms every single day. Because, like, honestly, back then was just the simpler times where everyone uploaded the same thing and like no one got mad, or the videos weren't like oversaturated like Fortnite. Because like now, like, I'm seeing Fortnite on my recommended, like every other video is a Fortnite video. I used to watch and play Fortnite, but like now the game just got too dull. But now my YouTube recommended list is just filled with Fortnite clips and Fortnite montages and stuff. But yeah, he actually uploaded a COD cutcom, and honestly, I hope he actually makes more, because that one actually turned out really good. Just watching that video brought back so many memories of just like back in, like, I would say the Black Ops 2 cutcom prime was like, I would say like 2014 to like 2018, 2017. Just like watching that video just brought back all the memories from back then. I hope he actually makes more cutcoms, because that one was really good. I hope the rest of the guys that were in red start making cutcoms again, so I can finally watch them again. Like, don't get me wrong, their Fortnite videos are pretty cool. I like watching their Fortnite videos, but it kind of gets boring after a while, like watching the same game over and over and over again, which is why I quit playing Fortnite. Was because, one, it was just getting too saturated on YouTube, and two, because like people just posted the same kind of videos. I mean, like, I'm doing it now kind of with these COD cutcoms, but like when it comes to Fortnite and like the whole Fortnite challenges thing, it was like I was watching the same video from like 15 different channels of the same Fortnite challenge. But when it comes to making COD cutcoms, like, it's the same thing technically. Like, we're all playing the same game, but it's kind of different at the same time. So yeah, I hope Kiwis and the rest of the guys actually start making COD cutcoms again, which would be amazing, to be completely honest. I've been thinking about it recently, and honestly, I might just start uploading every other day. I know in one of my recent videos I did talk about daily uploading, but I've been looking back at those videos and like they just seem too rushed, to be completely honest. And I was kind of rushing them at the same time just to get them out, because I thought daily uploading was easy. But just looking back at my videos and like just looking at the quality of them, there's just not that much going on in my videos to begin with. So I feel like if I just take that like extra day to just focus on making my videos like better, I feel like that would be a better choice for me, just to have that extra day to make my videos. Because I was making my video, making my thumbnail, and doing everything all in the same night. And I was up till like 3 a.m. just editing, making my thumbnail, and doing like all that stuff. But I feel like if I had that extra day, my videos would be higher quality, editing will be better, and everything else would be better with my green screen and the lights. If I get those like box lights, so once to my right and once to my left, I feel like that would be better for me. So that's all I'm asking for Christmas. And I might just save up for those L-shaped desks, because I feel like those look really nice in setups. And then after that, I might start saving up for dual monitors and like the monitor arm and stuff. Like, this is all a process. This all, like, my whole setup took me, I would say, like 2-3 years just to make. And it's still like not the best setup. It's a good setup for me. I've bought most of my stuff with my own money. I think the only thing that I actually got that wasn't bought by myself was my graphics card and my monitor that I'm playing my game on. I got my graphics card from my friend Ethan, which he blessed me a GTX 1050 Ti for free, which is pretty nice of him. And my monitor I got from my mom. It was a really old monitor and she didn't really want it because she didn't have anything to like plug into it. So she just gave it to me, and thank God it actually works with my PC and my game, because if it didn't, then this monitor is basically useless. That kid is so mad. But anyways, if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And also make sure to turn on post notifications down below, so you actually get notified when I post my videos. Because like, I feel like there's like at least like 10% of you that actually have my post notifications on, and the rest is just from either search or browse features. So yeah, if you guys do enjoy the video, once again, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Yeah, it's been your boy Zaire, and I'm out. Peace.